And then another thing we also showed is how you create these contracts by what we call play to create. We really know from our fans that they were really looking for us to create something for them where they could do their own custom contracts or their own custom hits. But we also knew quite early that we wouldn't really like to do an editor necessarily. We wanted it to be a little bit more both fun and have some other benefits. And that's why we came up with Play to Create, because when you're playing to create, you have to do it yourself. You go into the game world, you mark your targets, and we sort of measure what you're doing. Are you remaining undetected? Which order did you kill your targets? Which weapon did you use and all that stuff? And that actually shapes the contract for other people to play. And the good thing is that when they play a contract, they know that some player on the other end was actually able to pull this off, found this fun, clever, or weird, or something. And that's quite a good sort of feedback loop between players. So contracts mode really revolves around three simple principles. You have to kill your targets, then you have to escape, and then you'll get paid, basically. And the escape is actually quite interesting, because what we do is we allow for more and different exits to any point when you play a contract, because unlike the story, where 47 needs to really go from one place to the other, in a contract you're more in there to do a hit, and then you escape by any means necessary, basically. And that means that when you are tailoring the contract, when you are playing it and shaping it, you can choose either to go for an exit that's close to you, but that in turn means that the players who are playing the contract, they'll also have an easy time escaping. But you could also say, I deliberately want to choose something that's pretty challenging or funny, so I choose this exit instead. And then you actually have to make it to that exit yourself. And by getting to it, that's how you prove that that's the exit, that's the contract exit.
Oh shit! No snowman here! Okay, here we go again.
The contracts mode works in a way that we are monitoring constantly what you are doing as a player, and then we choose some of these key things that we know players are looking for. Were you unseen? Did you only kill your targets? Did you use a disguise? What weapon did you use to kill your target? And all of these things, we actually, in the end of a contract, we allow the player to use as bonus conditions for the contract. That means that if you manage to be unseen when you created the contract, you can have that as a bonus condition for people to say, you have to remain unseen if you want that bonus condition. You can also say that you have to kill the target in the exact order that you killed them. That will make the contract turn into more of a tour de force, if you will, or almost a speed run. Or you can say, no, that's not a requirement for my contract. You can say that you can kill any target with any weapon at any point. And that actually makes it a challenge to figure out, I have three targets and this exit, what's the optimal approach? Who do I touch first? And the way a contract works is that the first time a mark is hit, the first kill, that actually starts the clock. So you have this period where you can, this grace period where you can walk around, you can try to figure out what to do, but the first kill starts the clock and now you're on a timer, and then that's where it gets really exciting, right? Because now you're actually measured, you have to do the kills and you have to get out, and the time will actually give you a bonus as well.